I had some hip arthritis. What was really bothering me for probably for the last year, it's called athletic pubalgia. Happens to soccer players and people use their legs a lot, but it's just where the adductor muscles insert into the hips by the pubic bone, as well as the hamstrings, where the three hamstrings insert in the ischial tuberosity in the back, were like spasming. And ultimately what I found out was, after the MRI, I had little micro tears in those areas, which similar to like, it must have been from working out and stuff, but little micro tears in it causing the inflammation. And then when I went in for the MRIs, they actually said I had some hip arthritis, and so perhaps the affecting my gait hip arthritis was referring some of that inflammation in and around the area. And so what I actually had done was injections in both the adductor muscles and each side of the pubic bone, and each side of the ischial tuberosities where the hamstrings insert, in both hips intra-articularly. And then at the same time, because I said I was coming down here, I had annoying rotator cuff pain for 4 or 5 years. I would say I used to be a pitcher, and never bothered me, but the deltoid every once in a while, because I'm an orthodontist, I would hold a high speed to take braces off and stuff like that, and I just feel a little bit of a twinge, a little bit of a heaviness there, so I said, I'll check it out. Well, when they took the MRI, they realized that I had torn some ligaments in there, which I never knew, and it was referring pain to the deltoid, so I had them do an intra-articular injection into the rotator. So within 5 hours of having the deltoid as well as the intra-articular injection into the right rotator cuff, I was able to raise my arm full range of motion without it tweaking me in the deltoid. And the deltoid muscle, which had lift my arm even halfway, or again holding a dental drill in my hand, it would tighten up and be sore, is not sore, it's not now, and that occurred within the first 5 hours of the first day. And so now it's been 2 days, there's no pain in anywhere in the rotator or the deltoid. I can't even feel that I had anything. And then the biggest aggravation, what really brought me down here, was the athletic pubalgia, the adductor muscles that insert right here in your groin, right in the inguinal area. When I would go to stand up, I would stand up, I'd have to push off things, but I'd get to about this point and I'd kind of lock up and have to very slowly stand up, because these adductor muscles are super spasmed and tight and inflamed because of the micro tears, as well as the hammies in the back, that balance. And now I can just stand up, get down, and I'm a dentist, like orthodontist, so I do this about 100 times a day, and there's no wincing. I was glad I had a mask on, because I didn't want my patients to see me grimacing just standing up between patients all the time. So, and same with getting up off the toilet.
Yeah.
I'm not moaning, so yeah. Great. In the hips, I feel maybe, just because they said hips will do this, be maybe 20%, 25% of tenderness there. But it's tenderness, it's not pain. Whereas before, when I'd walk the mall here, each step I'd feel an ouch, ouch, ouch. And now I walk it and all I can feel is, you know, maybe a little tenderness there. And this is only 2 days later. So I am sure in the next few weeks it's gonna vastly improve. So scale of 1 to 10, it's a 10 in my book as far as what I came down here for. Oh, I not only would recommend BioXcellerator, I have 4 or 5 people at home that prior to come here, I've talked to them about some of their ailments, and they kind of let you be the guinea pig, Randy. See if you come home and you don't have like a 3 years growing on your head, because somehow that whole stem cell thing of differentiated and from babies. And I said, no, an umbilical cord's not a baby. It's part of the process to fertilize the baby, to all that stuff. So I think once they hear and have a conversation with me to understand how smooth and how rapid the results were, at least for me, I've got 2 of them calling Michelle this week. So yeah, I will be a strong advocate, because I'm angry that these people, I have a number of oral surgeon friends who have knee problems and they're slated for knee surgery. And I said, don't do it, that's insane. You have nothing to lose, you have a little bit of cash, so what? If you lose, you can always have knee surgery, but if you have knee surgery, you can't go the other way. So yeah, I will and will continue, because I'm a good advocate for you guys, because I've had some great relief.